Good morning and Jai Hind children. I welcome you all in today's live class of biology. Children, as we are discussing the chapter nutrition in animals, and we have explained some of the topics of the chapter. And in my previous class, I have explained the topic digestion of food in mouth in human beings. So I hope that you understood that topic. Now today I'm going to start the class with an activity. So in activity syllabus, you have the activity number 3, that to taste for protein in food items. So first I'm going to demonstrate you that activity, and after that I will discuss the next topic of the chapter.
Now, children, today we will perform the third activity of biology syllabus, and the aim and objective of that activity is to taste protein in food item. For this activity, we require the material, like we require some arhar dal. Here I have the arhar dal. We require copper sulfate solution. So I have the copper sulfate solution, and we require caustic soda solution. So in this test tube, I have the caustic soda solution. Now the procedure is that we'll take that arhar dal and crush it to make a fine powder. So here I have crushed the arhar dal and make the fine powder. Now some of this powder we will take in a test tube. So here I have the test tube, and some powder arhar dal I will put here. Now we will add some water, about 10 drops of water in it. And shake well to mix the water with the dal powder. Now you can see here the solution, which is light yellow in color. Now after the water, we will add about 2 drops of copper sulfate solution. So with the help of dropper, I will put about 2 drops of copper sulfate solution. Now, again mix it well. And finally, we will add the 10 drops of this caustic soda solution in this test tube. Now, shake it well, mix the substances together properly. Now, at last, you can observe that the color of this mixture of water, caustic soda and the powder of arhar dal gets changed after adding the caustic soda solution, and it's changed in dark purple in color. So this change in color of this solution indicates that in the food item, protein was present that we have taken. That food item is arhar dal. So we can say that in arhar dal, protein is present. That is why after adding the copper sulfate and then caustic soda, the color of that mixture gets changed to become dark purple. So, children, I hope that you understood this activity. Children, I hope that you understood that activity which are performed there to demonstrate you that the protein is present in food item. Now, come to the next topic of the chapter. Digestion of food in stomach. Children, remember that in my previous class I have told that as the food get ingested in the mouth, the saliva secretes from the in the mouth and it breaks the starch into sugar. But this breakdown of starch into sugar was not complete. It's partial breakdown of starch into sugar. Now, after that, the food passes to the next part of our alimentary canal, that is esophagus. So, esophagus is the second part of alimentary canal. It's like a small pipe, tube-like structure, which joins the mouth with our stomach. And food passes through it and goes to the stomach. As the food passes here, it moves forward in a wave-like movement. This is the pipe, a tube, that is esophagus. So when food enters here, after the mouth, the muscles of this esophagus get expanded and food easily passed or pushed forward. And again, after expansion of the muscles get contract. So while contracting, it applies a force to the food and that food pushed forward, and because of this expansion and contraction in the muscles of esophagus, the food is going to pass forward and finally it reaches to the stomach. And this kind of wave-like movement by the muscles of esophagus is known as peristalsis. So peristalsis is a kind of movement, especially it's a wave-like movement in which because of expansion and contraction of the muscles of this esophagus, the food is going to pass forward. And remember that, children, the same movement is occur in all alimentary canal. Because of that, the food is going to push forward either in esophagus and in small intestine and in large intestine. Okay, so I hope that you understood the meaning of peristalsis. It is a kind of movement. Which kind of movement? Wave-like movement by the muscles of this esophagus, small intestine and large intestine. Now, due to this movement, the food comes to the next part of the alimentary canal, which is very important part of alimentary canal, and that is stomach. So first I'm going to draw that and then I'll explain you about stomach.
The stomach of human being is a bag-like muscular structure whose shape is somewhat like the alphabet J. So J-shaped structure is there present, which is going to start after the esophagus and end at small intestine. So from here the small intestine is going to start, and here the esophagus is going to end. So this part is known as stomach. When the food comes from esophagus to the stomach, it's going to stay here for some time, for certain reactions, for certain actions. When the food get collected here, enters here, the wall of this stomach this inner wall of the stomach are going to release three different kind of liquids. The one is hydrochloric acid, second is mucus, and third is digestive juice. So these three liquids are going to release from the walls of inner walls of stomach, and they all are going to play very important role in the process of digestion of food. So just come one by one about these liquids, their function. So first one is the hydrochloric acid. As it is an acid, so it is responsible for killing the germs, bacteria which enter along with the food in our body. So due to acidic nature, it is going to kill all the microorganism which is harmful for our body. And the second one is the food that comes here in stomach for the complete digestion of the protein part of the food. It's going to mixed in the food, and then this digestive enzyme, this digestive juice, can break the protein part of the food into simpler form. Without addition of the hydrochloric acid, the digestive enzyme which released in the stomach cannot help to break down the protein of food. Now, the second liquid is mucus. It is a sticky substance which is going to apply all the surface of the stomach, all inner surface of the stomach, it's going to apply. Due to that, the stomach walls are protected from the effect of hydrochloric acid. So you can say that the mucus is going to play a role to make a protective shield inside the stomach, and this shield is going to protect the stomach from the effect of hydrochloric acid. So this acid only can kill the germs, bacteria, and it does not affect our stomach due to the presence of mucus. And the third liquid is the digestive juices. Some of the cells of inner wall of stomach is going to release the digestive juices, which are responsible for the breakdown of proteins into simpler form. So these all are playing an important role in digestion of food. Now, as the digestion that occurs in the mouth, that is breakdown of starch into sugar, that was not complete. It is partial digestion. Just like that here, this digestive juice also does not complete the breakdown of protein. Its partial breakdown of proteins takes place in the stomach. Okay, children? Now, after this, the food passes to the next part of our alimentary canal, that is small intestine. So now we will discuss about the digestion of food in small intestine. I hope that you understood the digestion in stomach. What happens with food in the stomach? So very simply, these three liquids are going to play an important role in digestion of food. Hydrochloric acid makes the food acidic and kill the germs. Mucus protects the wall of stomach, and the digestive juice act on protein and break them into simpler form. So our next topic is digestion in small intestine. Digestion in small intestine. Small intestine starts from the stomach and it is long enough, a long pipe-like structure in which the food is going to pass, and the complete digestion takes place here in small intestine. So it is the long long tube-like structure that is highly coiled, and it is the site, it is the place of complete digestion of food. So children, remember that. If the question is going to ask from you, where the food completely digested, so you must have to say that in small intestine the food completely digested, whereas in stomach the food partially digested. Okay, so this small intestine is an also important part of our alimentary canal, as here the complete digestion is going to take place and number of other digestive juices are going to add in the food in small intestine. So come one by one about those digestive juices that adds in the food in small intestine. The first one is bile juice. The bile juice gets produced in one of the largest gland of our body, that is liver. Do you know that, children? The liver is the largest gland of our body and it is responsible to produce the bile juice that play important role in digestion of food. This bile juice get produced in this liver, but it's stored in another gland, that is gallbladder. So the gallbladder is a small pouch like structure which attached from the liver, and all the bile juice after producing there in the liver get collected, get stored in the gallbladder. So you must have to know the names of the different glands also, children. So the first important gland is liver. In liver, what is going to produce? Yes, bile juice. And the second one is gallbladder. Yes. In gallbladder, this bile juice is going to stored. Here it is produced and here it is stored. And the third important gland is pancreas. Pancreas is an important gland which is situated just beside the stomach and small intestine here. Its structure is somewhat like a leaf of plant and it attaches here in small intestine and release its juice in the food in small intestine. So the pancreas is going to produce the juice, and the name of that juice is pancreatic juice. So the pancreatic juice that comes from the pancreas gets added in the food and also help in digestion of food. So in a small intestine, complete digestion takes place with the action of pancreatic juice that comes from pancreas, bile juice that comes from gallbladder, and some of the digestive juices also secreted from the wall of small intestine. So you can say that the small intestine itself going to produce some digestive juices. So these all digestive juices help to complete digestion of food. Now I'm going to explain you that what changes are going to occur due to the action of these different juices in the food. Now, children, the protein which is present in the food it gets breakdown into simpler form, and the name of that simpler form of protein is amino acid. So amino acid is the simpler form of protein. This amino acid can easily be absorbed by the blood. So that is why it need to convert, need to break the complex form of protein into the simpler form. The next one is the starch. This component of the food gets broken down into simpler form, and that is sugar, simple sugar. So starch converted into sugar. And the third one is fats. The fat part of the food also get converted due to the action of bile juice into fatty acids. So these three different breaks down takes place in our small intestine, and after that we can see the food completely gets digested as the breakdown of starch starts in the mouth, but it's not complete there, it's partial digestion. And when this comes, partially digested starch comes in the small intestine with the help of pancreatic juice that comes from pancreas, it's completely get digested and broken down into simple sugar. The protein which also start digesting in stomach because of the digestive juice that comes in stomach. So there also it's not completely digested. The protein partially digested in the stomach. And when this partially digested protein come in the small intestine, due to the action of pancreatic juice, this protein completely converted into amino acids. So these two conversion breaks down completes because of the action of pancreatic juice. Yes, children, you must have to know. And this conversion of fats into fatty acids, this takes place because of the action of bile juice. When the bile juice gets added in the food, so the fat which is present there in the food, they convert it into small droplets of fat, and after that, because of the intestinal juice, it converts it into the fatty acids. So these are the conversion that takes place in our small intestine, and the food completely digested. Children, I hope that you understood the digestion of food in stomach and the digestion of food in small intestine. Now, come to the next topic. absorption in small intestine. When the food completely get digested in small intestine, so that nutrients need to absorb, and this absorption takes place in small intestine. And for this absorption of digested food, the small intestine have the special structure in it. And that structure, just I'm going to draw, so just see that. As I told that the small intestine is pipe-like structure, tube-like structure. So inside that tube, if we see inside the small intestine, so the outer wall is smooth, but the inner wall is not smooth. It's highly coiled. It have number finger-like projections present inside the wall, and every projection looks like that, which have the blood capillaries. The blood capillaries are present throughout all the finger-like projections. Now, this finger-like projection is known as villi. And these villi are covered with blood capillaries. These villi, which are present throughout whole inner surface of the small intestine, help to increase the surface area inside the small intestine. And when the food passes inside the small intestine, all the digested components like amino acids, sugar, fatty acids, they all gets absorbed by these villi, the blood capillaries which are present to them. So the blood capillaries absorbed all the nutrients from the food, and with the flow of the blood, that food reaches to each and every part of our body tissues, body cells, and there they gets used up for different purpose, for different function. So the absorption in small intestine is takes place due to the presence of villi. Yes, very good. And these villi are having very fine network of blood capillaries, because finally the digested food need to go in blood. So these capillaries are responsible for taking out those nutrients, and these villi are going to provide the help to increase the surface area. So more and more digested food gets absorbed by the blood capillaries, which is present in small intestine. So Philip, I hope that you understood these topics, that first digestion in stomach, what happens here? Here the food partially digested, and which component of the food? Protein component, yes. And hydrochloric acid kills the germs and makes the food acidic. Mucus protect our stomach wall, inner wall, from the effect of acid. So these are the functions played in stomach. In small intestine, the different juices like pancreatic juice, bile juice, and intestinal juice, they all are going to act on partially digested food, and the complete digestion of food takes place because of the juices which present in small intestine. Amino, that protein breaks into the amino acid, fats breaks into fatty acid, and starch breaks into simple sugar, and after that easily they get absorbed by the blood capillaries which are present in villi. So children, I hope that you understood today's topic. Thank you and have a nice day.